Well, I suppose from the markets and the perception of the last couple of days, the expectation that it was going to be close, but we were likely to remain. So it was actually a very substantive shock, and still shocked when I got up this morning to see that we're going to leave. The British people have spoken, and we're going to be leaving the European Union. This is a momentous decision. It's going to impact on every person's way of life and the conditions, the economic conditions out there. It's got severe implications for business, investment, and for jobs here in Northern Ireland. Businesses are used to adapting, they're resilient, so companies will get on with it in the short term. Clearly, there's significant political instability, economic instability, financial instability at the moment. So I think the first thing is to try to get some calm and leadership. And in the days and weeks ahead, then we need to take responsibility, and we need some strong leadership, and consider what the options are and what are in the best interests of the company now that decision has been made. Well, we are already have been in the process, as many other organisations are preparing. We'll be running an event for our members in a few weeks' time to brief them, because I think it's fair to say many companies didn't expect this to happen. There's many others have been preparing plans both ways on the back of it. Clearly, from a Northern Ireland perspective, we just don't know what's out there, and that is the issue. From a business perspective, we want to have access to the single market. That's very important for our existing companies in Northern Ireland. It's extremely important for foreign direct investors coming in. Companies need access to migrant skilled workers. We just don't have the numbers of people locally for that. So that's one of the things in terms of the negotiations. And also that then plays into the cross-border issues. There's been a lot of debate of that in recent weeks. So clearly, in terms of the outcomes of the negotiations, which are going to take place over the coming years, we need to ensure that that is addressed. And the final one is, the UK already has 53 trade deals, so we don't want to give those up. We need to ensure that those are secured, and we're not going back to sort of square one on the back of that. So very significant consequences and a very wide range of issues. It's fair to say we haven't probably even considered, most businesses and individuals will not have considered all of them, but we are going to be in a poorer place. The evidence is still there. This level of uncertainty we're going to have going forward is bad for the economy and bad for investment, unfortunately. One of the key concerns is Northern Ireland is now less attractive to inward investors. Hopefully, as part of the negotiations, a key element of that is securing some part of the access to the single market, but that is unclear. So investors in the next few years who want to have access to the single market are very unlikely to come to Northern Ireland. I think it also means we'll have to work harder on the skills agenda. We'll have to work harder in the investment agenda to make Northern Ireland even more attractive. But it is going to be difficult until we get rid of that uncertainty. But we have a period of a number of years, and maybe perhaps several years, until the final negotiation is done to understand what trade relationships we're going to have with the rest of Europe and the rest of the world. Well, across the UK, the CBI represents over 190,000 companies. Here in Northern Ireland, that was a lot of small, medium-sized companies. We represent around 70% of the top 100 companies in Northern Ireland. A number of them have already been on to us, so in the weeks ahead, we shall certainly be consulting with them. Every one of those had an email from us this morning setting out briefly a short two-page, some of the consequences and implications. But this is going to evolve. There's going to be a massive amount of work in the coming months and indeed years in terms of going forward on that.